Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. This is P. Francis McNichol, and this is a low-budget video I'm doing right now, but it's more to help out anybody that might watch this video and knows about purchasing ammo. They have their own systems of buying ammo. They might look at other places like I do at AMMOSEEK.com. I seek out the smaller, lesser price ammo that still works. Hopefully it does. And it's not like the Precision 40 Smith & Wesson I bought over 9 years ago. I bought like 10 boxes of it in the green box, green and gray box. And every other seven or so rounds had a light primer strike or failure to eject or you name it, double feed. And it escapes me, even the Ford Smith & Wesson round, weapon I had at the time. But I was thinking it was a Smith & Wesson pistol. I'm trying to go back to that time and remember. In any event, that was the worst ammo I've ever seen interact with any handgun, revolver, pistol, semi-automatic, any kind of shotgun rounds, even steel case 223, which has been known to get stuck. The case, the casing itself gets stuck in the barrel and it won't eject. And people know how this basically occurs because the heat expanding so quick, whatever the material is on the outside of the steel case, whether it's a polymer, whether it's a lacquer, like the olden days, that 223 Russian made round or Eastern Bloc made 223 round had its issues. And there's less and less with better technology, better barrels, better feeding systems, better bolt and extraction units all together in an AR-15, so on and so forth. So I try to go as cheap as possible with stuff that I know that works. And I like the Tool Ammo brand in particular. And I haven't had hardly any issues with the Bear and all the other ones that were steel case with the polymer coating. I think at one time with one weapon, I had a casing that was stuck and it just solidified inside the Delton AR-15 I have, and I use the Delton now for parts because I just did not have a chance yet to knock out the casing. And it, every time I did try to pull it from the open chamber, even disassembling the whole upper of the AR-15 Delton, I couldn't get it out with just a knife or a screwdriver, just popping it right up and out. So my point is, I bargain shop for ammunition, and my main two rounds, or main three rounds actually, are 9mm for the handguns that I'll have on my side with a carbine, where I can reach out and touch someone within city limits, and I can affect change if I have to with a faster velocity 9mm and a very tried and true carbine. Regardless of what it is, whether it's a Linda, whether it's a Glock carbine I made into with a 6.2-inch barrel and a collapsible brace, whether it's a sub 2000, whether it's a Chris Vector 9mm, all the Vectors I like, they look just different, even though you might not use it tactically, because they're a little hefty. In their own right, and they're not, to me, they're not even as good as the sub 2000, which have worked flawlessly with my 9mm. Everything I've thrown at it, in it, spews it out. Okay, that's just how good the sub 2000s are, and people cannot talk smack about Kel-Tec anymore. Speaking of which, my 380 carry is the 3AT, okay? I carry it around with some CCI blazer in it. I've never had an issue with that. Those happen to be aluminum casings. So I'm perusing yesterday, and this is how I think. When I don't see a good deal on 9mm or 223 or 22, the main three ones I stockpile, okay? There's four, five, six maybe main ones that I stockpile that I continuously buy to this day. It's not 32 ACP anymore, but it's 22 long rifle, 223 AR-15 rounds, 9mm for handguns and carbines. And on top of that, I have 44 Magnum. Occasionally I'll buy. I still buy, and I look for great deals on that. 45 ACP, because I have more and more, I have seven JHP 45s for my family in the future, and they all work. And I've test fired them all, and they all are perfect to my specification. Fill it up with 10 rounds of 45 in there, one in the chamber, and it goes bang every time. I cannot complain about that with a $175 gun that has not let me down yet. Not saying it won't, not saying it's the best gun in the world, but for a 45 ACP, I'm not a 1911 fanboy. I'm not a Glock fanboy either. Glock has many different calibers. I do like the Glock 10 millimeter in general. I believe it's the Glock 20. I might be mistaken. Okay. And what I'm saying is the 45 ACP and the 380. 380 because there's lots of pocket pistols out there you can carry and you don't have to worry about it. It's out of sight, out of mind until you need it. And so I relegate myself to going elsewhere to those 45 ACP rounds occasionally, biting the bullet, maybe buying five boxes at the time. And they might be a little on the expensive side, but the shipping is low. So I work it out and I build up a case at a time, maybe over a longer period of time or not. 44 Magnum, very expensive compared to everything else. In the grander scheme of things, it's not so expensive you can't arm up with a 44 Magnum. I have three 44 Magnums now, revolvers, and I have a Rossi 44 lever action. I believe the year and the design and the make of it is a 92, like an 1892 model. And it has the side breech where you feed in the up the tube on the side. And very nice firing weapon, and that can reach out to probably 300 yards accurately and eliminate a threat. It could be used tactically like that, but it does have some kick. That's one of the drawbacks. It's lever action, so it's not semi-automatic so quick. You can still work at it. The kick feels like a shotgun blast when you're shooting basically, I want to say a 26 or 28-inch 12-gauge with double-odd buck or slug. It has some kick to it, and it has some heft. But my Rossi is a beautiful rifle I will never give away because it took me a while to buy it on layaway. And not that I'll always use it tactically, but for my range, I might put that in something like the ATV. I'm not a horse man. I'm not going to... Any estate I get, any land I get, there is no way I'm cultivating a horse for me to run around my property. However, an ATV or something like that, or maybe a smaller vehicle on my property, and I want to take that Rossi out and I want to put it in a sheath of some sort, I might go hunting. I might try to, liquidate, let's say, something like a feral hog or a feral dog around the ranch or any kind of animal that's injured that needs to be put down. Automatically, that 44 Rossi 92 is coming out, and it just does the job. I can take down big deer with it if I had to also, probably 150 yards away. I want to make sure I eliminate the deer or kill them quickly and humanely. And with the 44 Magnum coming out of a Rossi lever action, that's one way to do it. Anyways, so while I'm perusing and I'm looking for 9mm first, it has been the last 2 months, 3 months, every single time. The whole first page, about 20 companies on there for 9mm has them cheaper. Has them cheapest, but they're not the cheapest. They're actually, I want to say moderately priced to expensive. But if it's a low price box of ammunition, okay, very low, and it's a single box, it's a limit one box per person. Today, on AMMOSEEK, the first three or four companies, okay, or maybe it was the same company with four entries at the beginning. So you think you're going to be able to stockpile cheap and expensive ammunition that works in 9mm, and no, okay, because there's only one box per purchase. So you go down a little further and you see some good deals, what you think are good deals, and you're looking off to the right-hand side of the screen, and the little meter has down low red two or three for shipping costs. And if it's red, you're dead. If it's red, you're paying a lot. If it comes up a little and it starts to get brown, okay, closer to halfway, okay, how much is that going to cost you? It depends on the amount, of course. But to give you some examples, like I've spoken to before, two 500 bundles of 9mm could have came out under $200, okay, $169. And then you go to shipping and it's $254 extra for shipping, okay, in that ballpark. Okay, so it's a $402 exchange for basically one case, which is 1,000 rounds of 9mm. And it's not top name stuff like the Remington, okay, or even the CCI or the Buffalo Bore brands of ammunition. And you're like, wow, okay, that is not the manufacturer of the ammunition. Okay, that is not the distributor. That is the people gouging the shipping and charging you extra for the shipping and equating it to cheap 9mm. So it's bait and switch. They bring you in with a cheap buy, but they also get money out of you for the shipping that they say they're handling for you. One of them, I've said before, is Bestow in Maryland. And it was like $169 in shipping for about $150 worth of 9mm, which I believe was close to 1,000. That was another one. The $254 shipping charge was down into Florida, okay? And that was cheapest ammo, okay? There's another one called Best Ammo, and I believe it's the same company, and they changed their name. Where I ordered, I was looking over, 500 rounds and 10 boxes of 9mm, which is not that heavy. Yeah, there should be incurred some costs because it takes a lot to load up a lot of these packages and deliver them all over the United States. So I understand some cost is going to be about $30 for 10 boxes of 9mm. California, the Millwall Corporation or Millwall Group ammunition store, they already told me they have a contract with Brown or UPS, and their shipping costs, even all the way over here to Virginia, is $27 for all the 9mm, I'm sorry, the 380 I purchased from them, because they have the best 380 deals going. And sometimes it goes up and I leave them alone, but it goes back down. And I can buy bulk 100-round boxes at whatever price it is, but it's very inexpensive. And I'll get three or four, or maybe even five of those 100-round boxes. I have a half a case of 9mm. I'm sorry, 380 again. I'm thinking of 9x18 because I was reviewing those costs too. My apologies. Anyways, the 380 also can be bought and delivered $27 extra shipping for a half a case of 380. Okay. And so this company, best ammo, okay, I was like looking at the price and I was like, man, this is another almost $200 shipping cost for basically 5 boxes of ammunition yesterday. And I was like, you're crazy, okay? You're insane. So something at about $100, they used to cost about $100 with shipping for 5 boxes of 9mm ammunition, is coming out to over $200. It's $100 for the ammunition. You think it's great ammunition, and then it's $169 shipping. So I called them up. I spoke to a gentleman there, and he said, yeah. I couldn't tell his race from Adam, okay, but his voice sounded like Black American. He just sounded like a black man. I might be wrong. Please forgive me. He's like, yeah, I agree with you. I told the owner of the company that too. But he first tried to say, well, that includes all kinds of different things we do to make sure the shipping gets to you. And I was like what? You know, giving it to FedEx, turning it over to UPS, you know, driving down the road before you go home and dropping off these packages at UPS or FedEx, or having a contract with FedEx go to? He didn't give me an answer. He was a very nice guy, very polite, and he's put between a rock and a hard place because he said, I told the owners that the shipping is too expensive. So I'm like, okay, well, thank you. I do appreciate it. Have a nice day. And he was like, sir, I appreciate you calling. Thank you too. Super polite to me, very professional. And I really enjoyed that because the last person I spoke to who sounded like an Italian hood rat from New York City was not as kind. Okay. From Cheapest Ammo or whatever the name of that place was. And so I'm going down the list of AMMOSEEK for 9mm. And I see all these reds, reds, dark brown, red, 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 dark brown. And very few of them start to come up beyond the brown where they start to turn green at the 10% level. And that means the sellers of the ammunition is absorbing a lot of the cost, or they have a good contract with their deliverer, whether it's U.S. Postal Office or U.S. Post Office, USPO, or FedEx, or DHL, or UPS. And I was like going down and down and down. And some of the higher price ammo is moderate, okay? And you're paying $11 for a box of 9mm, where the very first ones are $8 a box of 9mm. And super high shipping costs, where they make all their money back, plus a lot of extra profit. And you go down here and you have an $11 box of 9mm ammunition, and the shipping is a little better. So it's like, okay, 10 boxes of 9mm, let's go see what it costs. Right on the nose, $169 delivery fee, shipping fee, what have you. And I didn't get really, I think it was Best, I don't want to say no lie, whoever it was, they're in on it. All these companies are working together to shortchange the gun owner and the gun enthusiast. Okay? So you have low price ammunition all the way up here. You can't buy any but one box a person. That ammo outlet, that ammo store selling that, let's say they have 50 boxes of that box of 9mm for $8 a box. They have 50 customers coming then to peruse their site and possibly buy other ammunition, but you went there only for one box of 9mm. Because they're that stingy, they're going to dole it out that way for no reason other than bringing 50 other customers to their site for one box of ammunition. So I like scroll down, keep on scrolling. And then the other unscrupulous businesses, they're like, this is a name brand pack of or box of ammunition, 9mm. It's $11. and that's overpriced by probably $5. Let's be realistic. It's easy to make the ammunition once you have the infrastructure in, and it's not guaranteed it's as good as a factory, or, you know, it could be reloads. Reloads can be better than even corporate companies, okay? It depends on a lot on the quality assurance, the QA, okay? Quality control, okay? $11 for the same ammo, maybe up the chain that's $8, but you go over and look at the shipping, you think you're going to get, you know, cheaper shipping. You don't get it either. So you're paying for the name brand of basic ammo that's not 100% guaranteed, or might not have a pristine track record like the CCIs, but it's a name brand, okay? And it's a corporate round. It's a corporate ammunition. And so these sellers in these companies are cashing in on our backs and our hard labor, fleecing us. So with this video, I am asking anybody who watches this video, please, because I've contacted AMMOSEEK twice now and received email notification about them and their own answer in print by email, that they're not going to get involved. And when you do a little questionnaire and you contact them, they don't have a phone number. Not on my phone anyways, and I went through every little entry and every little tree. When you hit the contact button and it asks you the topic, you hit that, and then you go through these little checklists that keep on checking. You have to hit the box because it says, we will not get involved with exchange disputes. Check it off. Then the next one is, we will not mediate any sales, blah, blah, blah. You go all the way down. And it says everything, so they have no culpability whatsoever on AMMOSEEK for regulating these swindlers, these really shady people that got into it for the wrong reason. And I can understand, because I did speak to one person that had nothing to do with with these high prices. It was a little higher where I bought 9mm one time from one place in Florida, and the guy was a veteran, and he said the company is his. It's veteran owned, and he hires mostly veterans. And he said the hurricane missed his business. It had standing water outside, but it didn't do any damage. And so he was open for business, but it did delay him. So he had to raise some of the shipping costs because those same distributors, those same carriers were not coming into Florida, because most of Florida was a wreck. And I understood that. So I placed an order anyways. Okay, I told the guy, all right, I'll wait till next payday, and I purchased ammunition from him, okay? And then the prices never went down. You know, nice guy, I'm sorry, but his was not even exorbitant as the ones, the cheapest ammo or best ammo in Florida. I think they're the same, because their shipping costs are outlandish. For 10 boxes of 9mm, $169, you know, carrier fee, shipping. How can they expect that? With a straight face, they expect you to absorb all the costs. And, AMMOSEEK is all right with letting them stay there the first 20, 30 entries on 9mm, you know, cheapest to more, the most expensive. Hundreds of entries for 9mm sales. And it's like, you can't find a good deal. You can't find a good deal for 9mm. Why is that? They're cashing in on 9mm because it's the most popular basic round that can basically do home self-defense, street self-defense, wartime self-defense, okay? I'm not talking about sniping, and I'm not talking about shooting people across the freaking valley a mile away or something like Afghanistan. I'm talking about more urban combat, okay? More stuff in woods where you can see your target quicker and you have stuff between you to defend yourself, so you're going to be closer and for closer combat, so to speak. A 9mm carbine might be all you need. And these assholes know it. So AMMOSEEK doesn't care. AMMOSEEK puts the choice there for you. They don't care when you're doing all this checklist all the way down. And they will not get involved, and they will not do this, and they will not do that. But I didn't realize this until the last conversation I had with the Millwall lady. She let me know that AMMOSEEK, yeah, they have to pay AMMOSEEK for Millwall to be on there. I was like, no, I thought it was a free service, and they would advertise a lot of stuff. And they were getting money from, I want to say, corporations that make ammunition, that make guns, that make gun stuff. And she's like, no, they're supported only by the ammunition companies that sell the ammunition, the retailer. So like, oh, so they do have a responsibility to us to rein in these crazy people fleecing the gun community. These people fleecing the gun community must think that we're all new rookies buying 9mm coming into our own. And that's another reason why 9mm is so popular, because it's an entry level round. A lot of people can shoot the first time and enjoy it. So I'm asking all friends that watch this video, contact AMMOSEEK, fill out that contact form where you just go down the line real quick. You might have to put your email in there and document in there your words, why you are upset with them, and you're going to hold off your business from them from now on. All right. That being said, yesterday, because this 9mm fiasco was this morning, yesterday I perused some of the 9mm and I didn't think twice about it. I'm like, I guess I'm not getting 9mm today. I went through 12 gauge, looking for 12 gauge double odd buck, because that's a good combat round. Any way you look at it, it's a good combat round. Whether one, it's a one shot tip up barrel shotgun that all our grandparents had, or it's a fully automatic shotgun, it doesn't matter. That's a great round for self-defense and wartime. And you have protection within, legitimately within 100 yards. Maybe not much more than that. And I saw a great deal for 25 in a box for $10. A box of 25, 12 gauge, shotgun, double odd buck. And I bought 10 of those. And it came out to $113 after shipping. You cannot tell me that the 9mm fleeces, the 9mm frauds trying to fleece us and their ammunition sales for 9mm, you cannot tell me the shipping is that expensive. Even in Florida, that was hurricane ravaged over 6 months ago now. So I made a purchase that way through AMMOSEEK, the company I don't remember right offhand. It sounded like a gun store company that had too much ammunition on their hands and they just wanted to sell it. And I don't know the average cost in general for double odd buck, a single round shell. It used to be, if I remember correctly, 10 rounds of 12 gauge double odd buck for something under $4 or something under $5, closer to $4. Okay, like $4.25, $4.35, something like that. And so I was thinking to myself, maybe I made out, maybe I didn't. You know, I'm not going to shoot 12 gauge double odd buck all the time. No one really wants to. But if you have to in a defensive situation, you know, street to street, building to building, house to house, in a mount-like situation, you can't go wrong with a 12 gauge. You know, it will remove doors for you. So anyways, thank you guys, and please contact AMMOSEEK. Write your dismay and displeasure in that comment section. Leave an email so we can all respond to them and tell them we're not going to stand for it. Okay? Thank you guys, and I do appreciate your time and energy in this matter. It's for all gun users, new and old, to enjoy reasonably priced self-defense if we all pitch in together and voice our concerns. Thank you, and have a great day.